Scientists have invented a machine that can detect emotions even if someone's expression doesn't change. Can you read what I'm feeling? Hey everyone, Amy here for DNews. Part of what makes us human is that we experience emotions, but it's still really hard to know what other people are feeling, especially when they're trying to hide it. So what if machines could read and interpret people's emotions for us? Well, scientists at MIT have thought of that, and they developed a device that can detect how you're feeling without even looking at your face. See, we display emotions not just through facial expressions and body language, but with our entire physiology, things like our heart rate, breathing, blood pressure, and sweat. These are the exact changes that lie to detectors look for when you're hooked up to a polygraph. But polygraphs require being physically plugged in, which is an awfully cumbersome way to get a read on someone's mental state. That's where MIT's device, dubbed EQ Radio, comes in. It works by bouncing radio waves off a person and analyzing how those waves are affected by the rising and falling of their chest or the vibrations of the pulse under their skin. With this information, it can measure the time between heartbeats and breaths and notice when they're speeding up or slowing down. The device then uses an algorithm to determine how the data matches up with different emotional states. Researchers trained it to recognize the emotions of joy, pleasure, sadness, and anger in 12 subjects, and it was able to identify these emotions correctly 87% of the time. And when it was shown a new subject it hadn't seen before, it could guess how they were feeling more than 73% of the time. The scientists think this technology could be used for things like market research, like telling a production company what you're feeling when you watch their movie. It could also help monitor people's emotional states for medical reasons, such as observing people with depression. But let's not forget about facial expressions, because the technology for reading faces is also getting better. 5 years ago, Google's algorithms could pick out faces less than 16% of the time, which isn't very impressive. Now, software is so good at seeing and identifying faces, apps on your phone can automatically swap them.
This is good. This is fun.
I hate this.
I'm not terrified.
I hate it.
Computers can measure the details of your face remarkably well, and by analyzing the relationship of certain points on your face, they can guess how you feel with surprising accuracy. According to a 2014 study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, researchers at The Ohio State University created a program that could identify not just the six basic emotions of happiness, sadness, fear, anger, surprise, and disgust, but a total of 21 complex emotions, things like happy surprise or angry fear. They took 5,000 photographs of 230 volunteers reacting to different scenarios. After pinpointing a variety of facial muscles that are used to express emotion, the software was able to identify basic emotions 97% of the time, and complex emotions almost 77% of the time. This could help us diagnose and understand people with autism who have trouble expressing emotion or people with post-traumatic stress disorder, and it may even allow us to learn what's happening in their brains when they feel complex emotions. So computers that know how you feel might just improve medical science, even if it is a little creepy. Oh no. Now they know I'm uncomfortable and it's just making me more uncomfortable. These algorithms that read your emotions wouldn't be possible without machine learning, the first step towards artificial intelligence. To learn why you shouldn't panic about HAL 9000 just yet, check out Trace's video on AI right here. Do you see emotion recognition as a useful tool, or does it give you the heebie-jeebies? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to like this video and subscribe so you never miss an episode of DNews.